All right.
We are at our next service call. Sorry, doggies. Nice manicured lawn. Very nice.
We can't answer the door right now, but if you'd like to leave a message, you can do it now.
Hi. Oh.
Come through the side door.
Side door?
Yeah.
Sure, no problem. Keep off the grass. Good morning, how are you, ma'am?
Good.
I think I have been here before, a long time ago.
Yeah, I think you did the interview.
Yeah. Many, many years ago. How you been?
Good.
Excellent. Let's close the screen. Okay, where are we going?
Down.
Okay, lead the way, please. Something about a thermostat saying no power.
Yes.
Okay. Wanna show me the thermostat?
Oh, the thermostat.
Yeah. Yeah, I remember this. Wow, a long time ago.
Yeah.
It's good. Wow, good stuff. Gotta love carrier. Older carriers. New ones don't really last that long anymore. No, not at least my experience. Your mileage may vary, but you got the older ones. Thermostat's dead. How long has this been out for?
Good question. A couple of days, I guess.
Okay. So no AC.
All right, I got my tool bag. I got my knee pad. I'm just gonna go right to the furnace and check for voltage.
All right, there's the switch and it is on. Okay. All right. So this is powered. And it typically gets its power from a separate transformer, which feeds a humidifier. The solenoid valve in the humidifier, but... All right, no float switch. You don't need a trap on an evaporator coil above a furnace. You need a trap on an evaporator coil before the blower. So if this was a downflow furnace, you would need a trap here because the evaporator is before the blower. But since the evaporator is after the blower, you do not need a trap here. This is a moot point. Filter is not the way it should be. Coil's probably dirty. All right, let's see if we have a light shining in there. See nothing in there. You guys ready? Oh, I just saw a light there, though. Oh, we have 24 volts. At least we should have 24 volts. All right. A couple things first. I don't know if my switcher is going to work with this. No. Fudge.
Well, you know, that'll work.
Voltmeter set to read voltage and AC. Let's get one lead on common and the other one on R. We have 11 volts. Common and R, 13 volts. That's a problem. Let's go to Let's go to a ground now from R. Let's see if I can get that in there. Right there and R. Wow, I'm only getting like 13 volts. Interesting. Assess the fuse. Continuity in the fuse. All right. What's up with this wire here? What is up with this wire? Using CAT Ethernet networking cable here on a wire. And there's a jumper between Y and G here, I'm noticing as well. Interesting. All right, let's check for 24 volts going out of this transformer. So here's our transformer. Incoming voltage is here, 110 volts. The red and the blue is 24 volt red, 24 volt common. Red and the blue go there. So these two plugs right there. Let's test those two. Just like that. And we're getting 14 volts. All right, we're getting 14 volts coming out of our transformer. That is not enough voltage. And that's a problem. So let's now check incoming voltage going to our transformer. All right, I disconnected the black and the white wire going to our transformer, and we are getting 122.9 volts. So we're getting 120 volts here. We have a bad transformer. Crazy. Not putting out the voltage. Not putting out half of what it's rated for. So there must be some electrical engineering genius that's watching this video right now can tell me that. It's like the phase is missing. We're getting half voltage. So let's kill power. That did not kill power. What did that do? What is the purpose of this switch? Yo, what's the purpose of this switch? Yeah, check this out. Volts. Still got 122 coming in. I used the fan center relay transformer. Interesting. Why only 20 volts? It's crazy. All right, new transformer. 21 volts. Something is wrong here. Something is very, very wrong here. Well, I'm only getting 21 volts. So, this part and this one, no bueno. I got this White Rogers 50M56X843. Well, let's just say that the thing's relay was tripping like that older woman who flashes me every morning at the shop. Tripping like she trips every single morning. She can't help herself. Got the new transformer installed though. I'm still trying to figure out why it's only giving me 21 volts. It makes no sense. It literally makes no sense. I have incoming voltage of 122. Could someone please explain this to me? Anyway, we're ordering the integrated furnace control from American Standard Train. We'll have that tomorrow. And I'll probably either come back tomorrow afternoon after Free Friday or Sunday or on Monday, Labor Day. Thank you so much for watching. Let me get your thoughts and feedback down in the comments section down below. And until next time, part two, be well, God bless, stay safe.